Kendall Oil keeps your car running at its best, no matter...
Ron Hubbell challenges John Mazinski Saturday on Beat the Champ. Hi, this is Van Miller. Saturday night at 7, a couple of really strong right-handers go at it on Beat the Champ. Our champion is John Mazinski of Buffalo, who's trying for his fourth win after three big 700 sets. The challenger, Ron Hubbell, a powerful Rochester right-hander. Don't miss the exciting competition Saturday night at 7 on Channel 4. It's Beat the Champ.
Into my brand new Prel bodybuilding system. New Prel shampoos in even more body for more fullness. And new Prel conditioner enhances all that body with better manageability. Because when it comes to body, Prel says, the more the better.
Men's Health Week, beginning Sunday at 11 on News 4 Buffalo. Channel 4 presents. From Kenmore Lanes in Kenmore. Beat the Champ. Here's your host, Van Miller.
Hello, everybody. A couple of really strong right-handers go at it today. With me is Mike Haynes, our color commentator and PBA member. And boy, John Mazinski, our champion, is on a roll, a 246 average, three straight 700 sets on the show.
He's just been destroying the pins here at Kenmore Lanes. He's got a great line to the pocket. He's went nine games without an open frame. It's just amazing.
And how about Ron Hubbell? Ron comes back. He's been on the show before, big, strong guy.
Another tough match game bowler. Should be a good match today. Ron throws a lot of strikes. Both players are going to be playing the same line. Should be exciting today, Van.
Okay, it is $400 to the winner, $200 to the runner-up, three games total pins. We'll be back in a minute to see if Ron Hubbell can beat our champion, John Mazinski of Buffalo.
Metzger's asks, when is a sofa not a sofa? What? When it's a genuine Lazy Boy quality sleeper. That's when sleepers with a Uniflex comfort system start at $549. And sleepers are available with full mattresses from $449. Get a Lazy Boy sleeper at Metzger's today, or sleep on it. Two great locations, Orchard Park and Amherst. Open 7 days a week, Metzger's Lazy Boy showcases.
Hey, excuse me.
Yes?
If Hunt's came out with a spaghetti sauce, would you give it a try?
Oh, if Hunt's made it, sure.
Sure.
What if it came in a can?
Hunt's has always canned the best tomatoes. Why not spaghetti sauce?
But what about the spices, the seasonings?
Taste it. Hunt's spaghetti sauce beat the leading national sauce 2-1.
Mmm, it is better.
Great taste and value.
It had to be Hunt's.
Hunt's spaghetti sauce, now at a new low price.
Well, you're looking at our champion, John Mazinski of Buffalo. He is 33 years old, 5'10". Weighs 210 pounds. He's averaged, as I said, 246 for nine games. He has rolled 716, 770, including a 296 and 728 in his victories, doing exactly that. And now we go to Ron Hubbell, 31 years old, 6'3", 240 pounds, out of Rochester. He lived in Buffalo for 5 years. He's had five 300s, a couple of 800 sets, including an 827. Carries a 217 average at the BIC Bowl and a 212 at the Gherkins Airport Bowl in Rochester. And he bombs one in there, too. So, Mike, it may be that kind of a neat evening.
Well, Kenmore has been a high-scoring condition the last 6-7 weeks, and it's an outside line. You can see Ron here. He gets the ball behind his back a little bit. His swing, you know, pops out a little bit, but right at the point of release, you can see the strong loft, and he's been bowling real well of late. He's won a couple weekend tournaments for $1,000. Should be a great match today, Van.
He's out of Penfield Senior High School, Monroe Community College, and the University of Buffalo, where he majored in electrical engineering and microprocessor design. Well, he's a driver for United Parcel Service for 4 years. He couldn't stand a desk job, he said. So. Enjoys jogging and music.
Well, Ron was bowling in the Proprietors Traveling League when he was still living in Rochester when he moved back, and he was coming back every weekend to bowl in the league.
And we go back to John Mazinski. Boy, he has really had a run on this show, trying for his fourth win in a row. By the way, Craig Woodhouse of St. Catharines, Ontario, one of the outstanding bowlers in the area, will be back with us next week to challenge our winner.
John Mazinski has been overpowering the lanes. He's played that outside line, but he's been hard to keep the ball in the pocket. A lot of the bowlers we've seen, if they let up on the ball will hook to the nose.
And he doubles. He's had a bit of a wrist problem, but boy, it sure hasn't been evident in his work here. It's cut down his number of games per week.
This week here's Johnny. You can see him, he's using a wrist support. He didn't use it for the first 2.5 shows. He just put it on the last 5 or 6 frames of last week. Doesn't seem to make much difference in his shot, though. Just makes his wrist feel a little firmer. Doesn't get the pain in it.
He's out of Grover Cleveland High School. Attended Bryant and Stratton. Has had 3 300s, 3 299. It's a 786 set. He's PBA member. He's rolling only 9 games a week, but really has been bowling very well. Boy, he got no break at all on that 5 pin. It just turned around virtually on its spot and left him with a 5-7. Now, he hasn't had an open in how many frames now?
Let's see. Well, let me see. 90
9
frames.
Games. 90
frames, 93 frames. That was really a bad break. That was a light hit, and the ball actually hit the 5 pin. Something came back off the kickboard, hit it back again, stood it up. It's not your normal 5-7 shot. It's all moved off spot a little bit. John should give us a good run.
How about it, John? Oh, yeah, he got it. So he still hasn't had an open now in 93 frames of bowling. That's incredible. What a great shot. And we go back to Ron Hubble.
See, John was really worried on these lanes. He moved deeper on the lane to catch more oil so the ball would go straighter. And just a perfect shot. Slid the 5 into the 7.
Yes, indeed. Here's Ron. Ron kind of moves that ball out and in, away from his body, and then brings it back, doesn't he?
But he gets it back in good shape, does the same thing every time. And right now, Ron is playing a little bit deeper on the lane. If you get the ball in too quick, inside your mark a little bit, the ball will hit more oil and skid. And right now, Ron's just struggling to get the ball to finish into the pocket.
Looking for another 2-pin here. He was an all-county athlete in 4 high school sports, football, basketball, baseball, and golf. And then concentrated on bowling and golf in college.
When did he have time to do his schoolwork, right?
Yeah, well.
Wouldn't want to get tackled by him, I can say that, that's for sure.
That's right. Also did very, very well as a golfer. Played on the same team with the current PGA man, Jeff Sluman of Rochester. His stroke average was 77.5.
You can see Ron Hubble's swing. Goes in, then he just bumps it out a little bit, but he gets it in good shape. Right through here is where it really gets back in the right position.
Our Channel 4 Super Slow-Mo Bowl Cam. And now we're back live to John Mazinski. And a shake and bake and a 10-pin lead. He is up early in our match by about 8 pins here.
Watch this hit. This is the hit that you normally leave a 7. It's a wall shot. Why the 10 stays, we don't know. The ball cut through the 6-pin, went around the 10. Usually that'll carry the 10-pin out and leave a 7-pin or a 4-pin. 4-pin, something light in the pocket.
John's wife is looking on here today, Mary Ann. They have 2 lovely children, John Jr., who is 8, Jennifer Rose, who is 5. And his dad is here.
Van, his, John's wife is lobbying for a new dishwasher. I keep kidding John. He says,
I think he's beyond that. He's up in a higher category after his three wins.
I said, you didn't get a new dishwasher yet? I said, you son of a... I was yelling at him.
...67 through the third with a spare in the fourth. Open with a double. And he's got a sliding pin there that caresses the 10 at the base, but it will not fall.
And we'll see the contrasting styles here of John Mazinski from behind. The same angle. He's a little straighter with the swing. He goes out just a little bit, but he keeps it straight in line. Good lift and turn. You can see the loft over the foul line.
John shooting a 10 pin here. His averages in league play are 206, 218, and 219. Bowls for Gene Rutkowski's Pro Shop, and that out at Southgate in the Sunday night mixed couples. Ron Hubble, by the way, was on a team that had one of the really high triple scores, three-man teams. Lived in Buffalo for 5 years. He bowled an 8-16, by the way, in that particular occasion.
In the league, I guess it's you bowl four games with three guys on a team, and they almost shot they almost averaged 1,000 apiece, which is a 250 average. I heard about that when it first happened, and the word sort of got back to Buffalo that I think it was Ron Hubble, and I'm pretty sure it was Mark McLean and somebody else, and they just went crazy.
Ron, by the way, is in the lead now by a few pins. He lost on this show to Carl Kenyon, 702 to 633, when Carl won those 11 straight matches. He says, ooh, and I don't blame him, Mike. That was a solid tap down there on that nine.
Lane seemed to be finishing a little bit harder than in the last few weeks. And a few shots in practice, we saw the ball cut through and leave a solid nine. John Mazinski left a couple of them on lane 11 in the practice session. Ball just jumps too much through the pocket.
Hubble up by two pins, assuming he converts this routine. Spare shot, and he does. We're going to take a little break now here from Kenmore Lanes on Beat the Champ. We'll be back with Mike Haynes right after this.
Prior to owning the Chevrolet, I had a Ford. Well, I switched to the Chevy because I liked the look better than the Ford. I found out that they had completely redid the truck. You need a four-wheel drive truck. You don't want to have to get out and lock your wheels in. If you want to go into four-wheel drive, you can just shift into it. This Chevrolet truck is the best vehicle I have ever owned.
Heartbeat of America.
That's the Chevy truck.
If you don't believe it, just go out and try it yourself.
Good morning.
The day's looking new and bright.
It's Monday again.
And you're gonna start it right.
Traffic's tied up.
Cause there's Folgers for you that's decaffeinated too. The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
A decaffeinated? And I'm waking up?
Nothing brightens your morning like mountain-grown Folgers decaffeinated. Mountain-grown coffee beans have more enticing aroma and richer flavor than any other kind.
Folgers so rich and good, the day starts like it should.
You know something? It's starting to look a lot better out there.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
Decaffeinated.
Zestfully clean.
Soap leaves a sticky film on you that won't rinse away. But Zest rinses you fully clean.
Zestfully, zestfully, zestfully clean. You're not fully clean unless you're zestfully clean.
While we were away, our three-time defending champion John Mazinski spared a 10-pin and then struck. And we're back now with Ron Hubble, who is up by a couple of pins here in the first game of a three-game total pins match. Hubble on 12. And he gets a late fall on the 10 and has his fourth strike of this opening game.
Jason, Ron Hubbell is a little deeper inside than John Mozinski. They're both playing the outside line. Ron's around the sixth or seventh board. John Mozinski is around the fourth or fifth board.
We're at Kenmore Lanes. They will give $1,000 for a perfect game, and John Mozinski took it right to the 12th and final ball a couple of shows ago. Here's Ron Hubbell. Looking for a double in the eighth frame, and he is there and leaves the 10-pin. I tell you that occasionally, because of time restrictions, we have to bowl through our commercial breaks on the show. We do that reluctantly. We don't like to have you miss any of the action, but inevitably we have to do it in order to fit the three games into the allotted one-hour time period, especially if we get fewer strikes and maybe bowlers who are take a little more time on the approach.
And right now, the 10-pin, the corner pin, has been a tough pin for both players.
Yes, sir. Mozinski left it three times.
And Ron Hubbell had a double in the fourth and fifth frame, a solid 9 on lane 11, another strike, and then a solid 10 on lane 11.
Now, John Mozinski can go up by about 7 pins with a strike here, which would give him the double in the eighth frame, first game. He got it. So John has his second double of this opening game, building up to a very, very good match.
See, with John Mozinski's game, he never really lets up on his speed. He really rips the cover off the ball, and he can play out. The lane is a little bit drier. You know, the fifth board and out, there's a dry area there. And some bowlers will play that, and if they let up a little bit, the ball will jump or overreact to the nose. John just fights right through that with the ball speed.
Looking for a three-bagger. No problem. He put that nicely into the pocket for his fifth strike and the first triple of the match. Mozinski has rolled a lot of strikes in those big 700 sets. He had 25 strikes 1 week, 23 another week, and 23 another week. Ron Hubbell sparing the eighth. Oh, another 10 pin.
Ball's breaking a little bit late. You can see just go around the head pin a little bit and bing, the solid 10. Maybe Ron is playing a little bit deeper inside line, so he's getting the ball to break a little bit later. Right now, it's just not kicking out the 10.
Looking for the spare here in the ninth frame.
Look out here.
Oh, it fell off into the channel, and we have our first open of the match. So John Mozinski has all of a sudden opened a 29-pin lead as we wind down the first game. What happened on that shot, Mike?
Well, Ron just got a little fast with the feet. He changed to a harder shell bowling ball and threw it a little bit too hard, and it skidded right in the channel. Open frame.
First ball, 10th frame. Needs to strike out for 206. That came in high, and he got a late fall on the 10, breaking up that split. I think he had that break coming, though, Mike.
Well, he bowled a fairly good game. He's going to shoot a few spear strikes. See the ball going here, high. He let up on the speed. 10-pin goes out late. But since the fourth frame, he's just wired the pocket and hasn't carried, missed the spear. Could have been a much better game for Ron Hubbell.
Looking for the spare in the 10th. And can finish up 196. John Mozinski, if he goes out, can go out to 245.
It's about his average, man.
That's right. 246 is his average for 9 games. That's amazing. He's found a home here. about it, Ron? Well, that's something to grow on for the second game as Ron Humble finishes up with a 196. His fifth strike ball. Mazinski opened with a double, picked up the 5-7 split, then had three straight spares, and now has had three strikes in a row. Something there that he didn't like, he stepped away.
Put his fingers in the ball, and he got a little perspiration on his hand, and went back, and he's reloading and going for four in a row.
First ball, 10th frame. And he gets the good mix there, and that's a four-bagger.
Real good ball speed. Now, this is a light hit. Now, watch the pins dance. Five-pin, head-pin, everything is flying around.
Follow the dancing pins in slow motion.
Even in slow motion, they went down pretty quickly.
Yes, they did. So John has four in a row. This is his second ball in the 10th that will put him up across 240 again, or above 240, if he gets it. Oh, where did that eight pin come from, Mike?
This ball, John pulls the ball a little bit, and it didn't really snap hard at the end. You can see it's a little bit light, but it chopped out the 10. The five pin goes in front of the eight. Leaves just an eight pin. It's not really a solid eight. It was sort of an in-between type of a hit.
And a 234 finish here. And a 38-pin lead after the first game for John Mazinski. Once again, a clean game. His 10th straight game without an open. We'll be back with Mike Haynes on Beat the Champ at Kenmore Lanes after this.
Lifestyles invites you to join Joker's Wild, Frank Sinatra, Jerry Lewis, and Sammy Davis Jr. on the next Jackpot Edition. The big toys in the fantasy playland of pint-sized giant Emmanuel Lewis. The ultimate thrill and chill for easy glider Cliff Robertson. Plus, Piazzadora gets the last laugh on the cynics as a mum and a star. It's a gilt-edged invitation you must not miss!
Saturday at 11:30.
This spring means great deals at your Dodge dealer's Spring Spectacular. Save $500 on Sporty Shadows in stock with over 45 standard features. Check out Value Packed Omni. Over 30 standard features for a low $5,995 base sticker price. Or save hundreds on America's best-selling family wagon, Dodge Caravan, when equipped with our Value Wagon Package that includes air conditioning. The Spring Spectacular is going on now at your Dodge dealer. Don't miss it.
It's gotta be a Dodge.
At Long John Silver's, we've got two new salads you'll want to dive into. Our new Chef's Combo Salad has waves of shrimp and chicken. And our Hawaiian Chicken Salad has tender all-white meat.
Looking for a place to live? Call the Peacebridge Apartments at 882-7000. The Peacebridge Apartments have clean, modern, furnished studio apartments. And for your living comfort, they now feature a whirlpool, sauna, and exercise and game rooms. Now, wouldn't you like to live here? Stop the search for an apartment and open the door to the Peacebridge Apartments. Rents include utilities and TV cable at the Peacebridge Apartments. 111 Porter Avenue, 882-7000. No leases required.
If you're not getting one-coat coverage from your roller, get the Easy Painter one-coater from Value Home Centers. Roller 3-pack is just $1.99 after fact.
We are back to the action here in the second game of our three-game match on Beat the Champ. While we were away, Ron Humble had a couple of strikes sandwiched around a converted four-pin. John Mazinski converted a four, then a ten, and has just struck in the third frame. He is up in the match by 37 pins. And we're in the fourth frame of the second game. And again, because of the pace of the bowlers, we have to bowl through our commercial breaks. And we don't like to do that, but we have a couple of very, very deliberate bowlers working the show. And there's John Mazinski doubling up now. That's his eighth strike. He has now gone amazingly 104 frames without an open on Beat the Champ. That's an amazing mark.
See, Van, too, it's a little warmer in here today with the lights and everything. Both bowlers take a lot of time getting their hand dry, and it just makes for a little slower pace.
Hubble looking for the double here to keep Mazinski's lead out of the 40s, and he's got it.
See, right now, Ron Hubble has moved deeper inside. Right now, he's hitting right around the 8th or 9th board, straightening the shot out a little bit, and just a solid strike for a double. You can see if we can see the ball, it'll hit right around the second arrow. John Mazinski, you really can't see it go over the arrow, but it was right around the second arrow. John Mazinski is still playing out where the lane's a little bit drier. Needs one here.
Down by 37. Oh, he came in high and paid the price. Well, I think he maybe lost a little speed on that shot, didn't
well,
he?
Right, he got that was a little bit slow, but he got the ball out where it's a little bit drier on the lane. The ball hit out about the sixth board, and when it hit that, it overreacted. It jumped to the nose and left the big four, the double pinochle.
A 4, 6, 7, 10. It's been made, but not often. Well, he gave it a pretty good try, Mike. So Ron Hubble now has lost some more ground in our match. John Mazinski, the methodical man, is up by 54 pins. He came into the match today averaging 246 a game, opened with a 234.
You can see Ron Hubble trying to slide this over. Really, he's trying to get two, maybe three. And he gives it a good shot.
We're back live, and you see the late fall on the 10, and John says, I'll take that one, and that's three in a row again. He's starting to string those strikes, Mike.
Well, he got a nice little break. He threw the ball a little bit extra hard, and he really had him dancing. He had about six pins in a pit, four on the deck.
Boy, he has really lengthened his lead now. It's out to 64 pins, but we have a long way to go here. Half the match. So a lot can happen, but John Mazinski trying for his fourth win in a row. And now his string of frames without an open is up to 105. Oh, look at that nine pin.
That's the same solid nine that we saw Ron Hubble leave in the first game on the same lane. Lane 11 seems to be snapping a little bit harder in the back end of the lane. And that just, it cut right through the heart of the pocket, chopped the five straight through off the nine.
You just wonder how long John can go without an open. I mean, this is unreal. And, of course, there's an old axiom in sport, you know, when you get into a long winning streak, with every win, you're that much closer to your next loss. And he just has been unbelievable. We're at the midpoint of the match here at Kenmore Lanes on Beat the Champ, and we'll be back with Mike Haynes after this.
It's the Battle of the Rosies.
This Rosie's got the big towel.
This Rosie's got the quicker one, Bounty.
And they're off.
No Rosie!
Bounty's the quicker picker-upper. See?
I'm gonna change my towel, Rosie.
But not your name, Rosie.
It's a new house in your first day, but you'll wake up your favorite way. Cause with Folgers to prove, the aroma's calling you.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
Nothing brightens your morning like mountain-grown Folgers. Mountain-grown coffee beans have more enticing aroma and richer flavor than any other kind.
That rich aromatic blend is your best morning friend.
Start you out feeling good. The day goes like it should.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your cup.
Look, there's one more thing. I'm thinking of hiring a college kid to replace Davis.
You're kidding.
Honor student. Yeah? I'm not too sure. He strikes me as a very determined guy.
Yeah, but isn't a college kid a little young to handle that job?
Maybe.
Move out!
But this guy's an Army lieutenant, Bob. ROTC has been training him for the last 4 years.
All right. When can I meet him?
Army Reserve Officers Training Corps. The smartest college course you can take.
Hi,
I'm Brian Winston, the gigantic winner Chevrolet in Amherst, where we have over 1,000 cars and trucks to choose from. We have this 85 Caprice for only 55 down, 185 a month. We have this 85 Celebrity for 55 down. Call 716-837-7600. That's the gigantic winner Chevrolet at the Millersport and 290, where winning people meet.
The gigantic winner Chevrolet at Millersport and the 290, open Monday through Saturday, 9 to 9.
If you're not getting one coat coverage from your roller, get the Easy Painter One Coater from Value Home Centers. Roller 3-pack is just $1.99 after factory rebate, or choose this 2-brush set for just $3.99 after factory rebate during value-packed bargain days. Value Home Centers' biggest sale of the season.
Holding your storm door open is easy with this bump and close auto hold from Ideal Security. Sale price is $5.44, or choose either of these latch sets for just $3.99.
Value Home Centers, for the do-it-yourselfer in you.
Ron Hubble struck and converted a four-pin during our break, and now we're back to John Mazinski. 106 consecutive frames without an open, leading by 64 pins in the match. Comes in high, and up pop the devil. And it looks like maybe the string is going to come to an end
here. You jinxed him, Van.
No, I didn't.
You said 106 right before that shot.
Well,
first time, John pulls the ball goes to the nose, but hey, you never know. John made the 5-7 split. He'll give this a run. Look at this.
Oh, boy. I mean, he gave it a great, great try. So the streak is over. 106 consecutive frames without an open. And he left the 6-7-10. And look at this try.
You don't think John knew what he was doing? He was going after it.
He certainly was.
People don't bowl a lot. You don't know how unbelievable that a streak like that is. It's just amazing.
Indeed. And now a 10-pin.
See, the difference right now in this match is John Mazinski is playing the lane farther out to the right where it's been a little bit better carry. You see a half pocket, weak 10-pin there. Ron Hubble is playing a little bit deeper inside, and he's having trouble getting the 10 and sometimes the 4-pin out.
Mazinski will shoot the 10. He's up by 50 pins in our match and has a new streak going here now.
One frame.
That's it, right? Beat the Champ is the longest-running television bowling show in the U.S. This is the 31st season on Channel 4. And we've enjoyed this season here at Kenmore Lanes for the first time. Ron Hubble now trying to make some inroads into this lead. Good shot there. His 10th strike of the match.
You can see, Ronnie, he had the ball in the pocket and he sort of coaxed that 10-pin out of there. I think he's at the point right now he was figuring to leave something on that hit.
Down by 50. Really needs to put some strikes together now and cut into that lead going into the third game.
Biggest shot of the match right here, Van.
How about it? No, he didn't get there. Broke up the bucket, but leaves a testy little 2-5. That's a very choppable spare.
Ron thought he hit his mark. The ball on lane 11 just seems to hang a little bit. He's a little farther inside. Got a nice little break getting out the 4 and the 8. Still a tough spare. You can see the 2-pin it's opened up a little bit. The 2-pin is off spot to the left. There's a little more room to chop.
And he gets the ball on both pins. So has the mark. And we're back to John Mazinski trying for his 4th straight win. With 3 700s coming into this 4th match. frame. And he is in the pocket. 10th strike.
Now this 10 pin, watch it, man. It doesn't get hit much.
Slow-mo fall
just,
on it.
Just enough. You can see the head of the 6 pin just knocked it over.
Mazinski would have to strike out for 224 after opening with a 234. Hubble can get to 202 by striking out. So John can really do himself some good with another one here. And he gets it. He has had the ability in his win string to put those strikes together. String of consecutive closed frames, he converted a 2-8-10 split. Fran, yeah. Of the 5-7, but he hasn't had, he didn't shoot at a lot of splits.
He didn't shoot any splits, Fanny. He had very, very few two-pin spares. It was either a strike or nine, and when he did leave a 2-8 or a 6-10, he covered it perfectly.
He had a 2-4-8, a 3-6-10. So John Mazinski here goes to 213 with this conversion and will take a comfortable lead into that third game.
Okay, Ron Hubble, after one game, was down 38 pins. The best he can shoot this game, if he would strike all the way out, is 202. Be down 49.
Drills that one. His 11th strike of the match. The last four strikes Hubble has had have come over on lane 12, where he's on the approach now.
Lane 11 for Ron Hubble has been his tough lane all day. Either it hooks too much or the ball hangs. Lane 12, he seems to get a nice reaction. His ball's reacting great.
Well, didn't really mean an awful lot, leaving the 8-10 at this point on his final ball, but he would like that. Would have liked that strike.
Yeah, he'd like the double, but he threw that one a little bit too hard. He got in the oil too long. Ball finished late, hit weak, left an 8-10 split.
So Ron Hubble, another game in the 190s, this time 191, coming off a 196, and he is down by 60 pins, and we'll be back with game three after this.
Excuse me.
Yes?
If Hunt's came out with a spaghetti sauce, would you give it a try?
Oh, if Hunt's made it, sure.
Sure.
What if it came in a can?
Hans has always canned the best tomatoes. Why not spaghetti sauce?
But what about the spices, the seasonings?
Taste it. Hunt's spaghetti sauce beat the leading national sauce 2-1.
Mmm, it is better.
Great taste and value.
It had to be Hunt's.
Hunt's spaghetti sauce, now at a new low price.
Stand by, Eggman.
Hello, I'm Mimi Lou Harris. Welcome to the Country Music Hall of Fame in Nashville, Tennessee.
But on the other hand, there's a golden band.
This year marks our 20th anniversary. 20 years of great country music.
45 of country's greatest hits.
She's a good-hearted woman in love with a good time and man.
You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucy.
You come again.
This collection represents the very best the country has to offer, and we're proud to share it with you.
Now I'm crying.
free to the first 1,000 callers the Country Music Hall of Fame commemorative book. This 56-page full-color volume features the careers and memorabilia of country's top superstars. The Country Music Hall of Fame's 20th Anniversary Collection. 45 of country music's greatest hits on 4 LPs or 3 cassettes, just $19.95. Or on 3 compact discs, only $29.95. Plus free this commemorative book if you order now.
To order, call 1-800-424-1700. In Canada, call 1-800-634-1200. Or save COD charges and send just $19.95 for 4 albums or 3 cassettes, or $29.95 for compact discs. Plus $4 shipping and handling to Country Hall of Fame, Box 206, Orchard Park, New York. Canadian orders at $5.
Ron Hubbell has just converted a 6-7-9-10 split to save a mark in the first game of the third game after John Mazinski opened with a strike. Mazinski up by 60 pins, and Hubbell comes back with a strike. The strikes are even, but Mazinski has been able to put them together and has had only one open frame.
Every time John Mazinski has had a single strike, he's followed it with at least a double or a triple. He hasn't had one single strike where he's failed to convert to double.
And he's in that situation now after striking in the first frame. This is Van Miller with Mike Haynes. We're at Kenmore Lanes on Beat the Champ. John Mazinski trying for his fourth win in a row. And he does it again.
Because of the firmness of John, he doesn't get the ball. He never has the ball jump on him with the harder shell urethane ball that he's using. Just a great reaction. If he used any kind of softer ball, he wouldn't be able to keep it in the pocket.
Opens with a double here. Third frame, third game. 234 and 213. And high and wow. Well, he's got what they call the Greek church.
Just what I said. I said he doesn't seem to go high. What's he do? He lets up just a hair, pulls the ball inside his mark, and this is the first real trouble. Ron Hubbell now can get back in the match if he would throw a couple more strikes.
Mazinski shooting the 4-6-7-9-10.
So what happens, you lose a lot of count on a split like this, on a double.
So he is open in the third frame. And if Hubbell is going to make a move, the time is now. You got to put a couple in there.
See, a couple more strikes, he can go down 31 pins. But he's got to have one here.
Oh, yes, he got good finish. His 13th strike ball.
Ronnie's he's owed a couple of breaks on in-between hits. This is the one he has to have. It's a light hit. It looks like the 7 is going to stay. Headpin jumps up, hits it on the top. Big shot here, Van.
Looking to cut the lead back to 31 pins. Needs the strike to do it. Fourth frame, third game. Oh, yes, looking good. That's the first time in the match that Hubbell has put 3 strikes in a row together.
See how John Mazinski responds to some pressure. This is the first time he's really been pressured in 3 weeks.
He's been a great, great front runner with these big scores. I mean, he has led from wire to wire in all 3 victories. Here's John on 12. And right back.
A little extra firmness. He's a little mad that he let up on lane 11. We'll see now if he thinks a little bit about his last split on lane 11 or just lets it rip.
Strike in the fourth frame. 51 through the third.
It's sometimes you'll have that thought in the back of your mind, well, I just split on this lane, I better throw it a little bit harder or move a little bit on the lane. Or...
looks good. Yes, indeed. So he comes right back and answers Hubble's double.
Just an excellent shot by John Mazinski. Puts the pressure. Yes.
Yeah. Hubble needs the strike now. Fifth frame. He's running out of time.
Oh,
he missed the spot there, but it came right back. It looked like he was going to go high on that shot, Mike, and I think you thought so, too.
He did. He should have.
Maybe it's the arm swing that misled us, but he looked like he missed the spot.
He goes, oh, no. Oh, yes. Watch this. He says, I deserve it.
Yeah, I'll take it.
See, Ron's playing deeper in on the oil, so that time he pulled the ball, didn't get the good lift, so the ball just stayed right there. Solid in the pocket.
Looking for five in a row here in the sixth frame. He's still in it if he strikes here, and he's got to come up. Oh, that finished a little bit too much for him and left the four pin. And he realized the importance of that strike to him. But it's not over yet.
Swung that ball out nice. Lane 11 jumped on him. When he gets to that certain spot in the lane, the ball jumps.
So Hubble will clean up the four, and we'll be back with our match right after this timeout.
I'm Chuck Metzger, the original Lazy Boy himself, but not when it comes to offering you real value, selection, and service. Visit our showcases. See for yourself our extraordinary selection of Lazy Boy recliner rockers, sofas, sleepers, and modular furniture. And Metzger's wants to make sure you're sold on us, even after the sale. And we'll do it with service, selection, and style.
World's greatest chair sale now in progress.
My dad, I worry about him. He smokes and never exercises. I wish he'd take better care of himself. After all, he is the only dad I've got.
My husband is so stubborn. He never visits a doctor, not even when he's sick. I don't know what I'd do if I ever lost him.
A man's lifestyle may affect his lifespan, and so may just being a man. I'm Dr. Peter Ostrow. Join me for a look at common male health problems during Men's Health Week, beginning Sunday at 11 on News 4 Buffalo.
It's the season finale of Dallas. And this time, when Bobby steps out of the shower, anything can happen.
I can't imagine why.
I saw a plan.
It's one surprise after another, leading to the most shocking cliffhanger in Dallas history.
Nobody's going to stop me now.
Then, there's a funeral at Falcon Crest. But is it for Lance and Melissa? Or Richard? Or could it be for Angela?
They wouldn't dare.
Find out on the exciting season finale tonight after Dallas, starting at 9, 8 Central and Mountain.
Love one another, and bring each other home.
Come together as a family. Come together to your house of worship every week.
Worship together.
A message from Religion in American Life.
Want to know what to look for in a car? This. A seatbelt can keep you from being thrown out of the car, and that's the main cause of death in car accidents. It can keep you from crashing into the windshield. It can keep you alive.
We're back at Kenmore Lanes, and John Mazinski, our champion, has just rolled a double during the break, and he has hit four in a row now and has pushed his lead up to 52 pins.
Just answered right back. Ron Hubble got within 30 pins. John Mazinski came back with a four-bagger.
Now let's see if Ron can stay alive here. But now he needs Mazinski to back up with a couple of opens. Oh, yes, beautiful shot by the Rochester challenger, Ron Hubble. But John has really come on since that wide open 4-6-7-9-10 split. After that, he really bore down and has rolled four straight. He's up in the eighth frame now.
John Mazinski would need to throw another open frame and Ron Hubbell would have to strike all the way out for Ron to win.
Mazinski in the eighth, looking for five in a row. Came in a little high that time and breaks him off at the four-bagger. He had some split worries, I think, when...
Yeah, you can see that ball just jump at the end. Sometimes you're going to leave the 4-9, just the 4-pin.
No problem. And now Mazinski moves over on lane 11 to bowl his ninth frame.
All John needs is two marks the last two frames, and he can't lose. But if he would mark here, then Ron Hubbell would have to strike all the way out to force John Mazinski to mark an attempt to win.
Ninth frame.
Look out, it's on a nose.
Well, again, he was nosing around and left the 3-6.
Lanes seem to be breaking down just that little bit. And John, he left the Greek church on this lane. It hooks a little bit more. Just leaves the 3-6. It's a very choppable spare.
Using his strike ball, he did not go to the softer cover ball and managed to get it. A lot more space down there between those pins than you would realize. And you know that if you're an ex-pin boy. You realize how far apart they really are. Very deceiving from the approach. Here's Ron Hubbell. Must strike situation, ninth frame. Nope, he leaves the bucket and we'll have our reigning champion winning his fourth straight match. And he'll have a tough guy to beat next week in Craig Woodhouse of St. Catharines, Ontario, a man who won $250,000 in one bowling tournament. Back live for the bucket shot. Ron Hubbell takes it off. Ron could not get the strikes together here today, Mike.
Especially in the first two games. The first game, he bowled just an excellent game. All I hit was 190, 196 to show for it. Could have had a lot more today.
Pretty good hit again and leaves the 10 pin. So he's going to finish up here with an excellent game. He can go to 234 with a conversion and a full count. But he needed another one of those along the line, in fact, a couple more. So John Mazinski, who came in averaging 246 over nine games and who won 106 frames before he left an open frame, will take his victory lap here at Kenmore Lanes. And their big $125,000 Greater Buffalo Tournament is underway, a handicap tournament, one of the fastest growing bowling tournaments in the U.S. So John Mazinski just cleaning up his business now as he wins his fourth straight match. And he's closing in on that $2,000 in prize money on the show.
Dishwasher's coming, Van.
I think so. I would say that if he won't make that concession to his wife, Mary Ann, that she's in a lot of trouble.
No, he's in a lot of trouble.
Oh, I see. Okay. Well, he will not hit 700 for the first time in four shows, but he'll have a good solid 600 set. Well, that's a good place to leave the bucket if you're going to. And John Mazinski finishes up the match with a very solid 659, and we'll be back right after this.
Good. Good news from the good people at Paddock Chevrolet. Chevrolet has extended its rebates, and that means a savings opportunity for you at Paddock. Drive home the sporty S10 EL pickup from $76.31. Experience the trend-setting technology of Chevy Nova from $82.26. Or the open-road excitement of Camaro from $10.521. That's just some of the good news from Paddock Chevrolet, where the news just gets better.
Because we're good people, too.
We're committed to your satisfaction.
Go, go! Go, Johnny, go!
All right, it's another Solid Gold Saturday night.
Hello, baby!
Time Life Music presents the rock and roll era, 1958.
The
22 solid gold hits by the original superstars. Now at the special introductory price of only $9.95 for two LPs or cassette, $11.95 for compact disc.
All of my love, all of my kissing. You don't know what you've been missing, oh boy.
Oh boy, Rock and Robin. Rock and Robin.
Splish splash, I was taking a bath. Long about a Saturday night.
After you purchase 1958, you'll have the opportunity to audition other great albums from Time Life's rock and roll era.
Good golly, Miss Molly. Show like the ball.
Take out the papers and the trash.
To introduce you to Time Life's rock and roll era, 1958 is available at the special introductory price of only $9.95 for two LPs or cassette, $11.95 for compact disc. Only from Time Life Music, the name you can trust.
Call 1-800-634-0600. In Canada, call 1-800-826-9800. Or send just $9.95 for two albums or one cassette, or $11.95 for one compact disc, plus $2.50 shipping and handling to 1958, Box 206, Orchard Park, New York. Canadian orders add $3.
So John Mazinski is our winner for the fourth straight week. Come on out here, Ron Hubble. I thought, Ron, I thought you had a big game going in your first game. I thought you really ran into some tough luck there.
Well, the first game I bowled well. I just couldn't carry. And John, that was the difference. He carried, I didn't. I dug myself a hole, and I just spun my wheels ever since.
And you had a great opportunity there, too, where you needed a double. You know, you just
I couldn't catch him. He had the edge, and he bowled well. Deserved to win.
Okay. Hey, listen, Ron, take $200, our good wishes, and good luck down there in Rochester, and I know you're going to be back on the show.
I sure will. Thanks
a
lot.
Good to see you. Thank you very much. Ron Hubble. Okay, partner. Well, Big Bad John, what happened? I have to ask you two questions. What happened after 106 straight frames without an open, and are you going to buy the dishwasher?
I'm going to buy the dishwasher. I better buy the dishwasher.
There you go. You heard it, Marianne.
And I'm only human, you know.
That's right, yeah.
So that's it.
Have you ever gone that many frames without an open to your recollection?
I don't know. I've never counted. I'm usually pretty good with spares, but to go that long without an open, that's
it's remarkable, really, is what it is. Really. And then you had the Greek church, but then you bore down again and put four in a row.
I knew I better, because Ronnie's capable of coming back with a big game, so... Hey, we did the best we could, and it worked out.
Well, he sure is. Here's $400 for the fourth week in a row, and a toughie for you next week, Craig Woodhouse.
Craig is real tough. I better be on my toes next week.
Okay. How's the wrist? Feeling all right?
It's a little sore, but we're going to try to hang in there.
Okay, John, thank you. Good to see you.
Thank you.
John Mazinski. And he is our champion for the fourth week in a row. He came in with three straight 700s and a 246 average, and today settles for a 659 and is now headed for that $2,000 plateau. But there's a tough guy waiting in the wings in Craig Woodhouse out of St. Catharines, Ontario. That will be our next match on Beat the Champ. This is Van Miller for Mike Haynes at Kenmore Lane saying, keep rolling those strikes out there, and we'll see you next week right here on Beat the Champ. So long, everybody.
Beat the Champ from Kenmore Lanes and Kenmore is sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress and the Women's International Bowling Congress.